Well, this is how. Are you all able to open this? So this is your RC coupled amplifier. So it has given you the instructions. The source voltage is set to 50 millivolts. Just remember this. Take out your notebooks. VI is 50 millivolts and the input frequency is 1 kilohertz. Take the screenshot of this. This is the instruction. The instruction says, yes, keeping the source voltage constant, vary the frequency from 50 hertz in regular steps. Set the source resistance as 100 ohms. Make a note somewhere. Set the collector resistance to RC to 4000 ohms. Then the emitter resistance to 1000 ohms. The emitter resistance is connected to 1000 ohms. Then load resistance is 2000 ohms. The load resistance is 2000 ohms. Just remember that. Those instructions. RS is 100, RC is 4000, RE is 1000 ohms. Let's remember all those things. RC, RS, RE, RE is 1K, RL is 2K, RB1 is 47K. And RB2 is 10K. The coupling capacitors are 10 microfarads each. Coupling capacitors are 10 microfarads each. So having fix these values. Let's fix RS. RS is expected to be fixed at 100 ohms. So as you change, you are able to change this. Yeah, that's 100 ohms. Then RC, next RB1. You are expected to give RB1 is equal to 47. Where is RB1? RB1 47K. Forty-seven K. And RB2 is 10K. So 10,000 ohms. Next, RC. RC you are expected to keep 4K. So RC 4K, 4000 ohms. 4000 ohms. Then RE is 1K. RE 1000 ohms. So thousand ohms, right? RL is 2K. That is RE. Is 2K. That's 2000 ohms. Fix it at 2000 ohms. Yeah. What else we have to fix? CE. CE. Can someone tell me what was the CE? Just go to instructions. The coupling capacitor CC1, CC1
10 microfarad, ma'am.
CC2 also coupling, these two, CC1 and CC2 are called coupling capacitors. So that's also 10 microfarads. One of you please show me, tell me what CE was.
10 microfarad, ma'am.
CE is bypass capacitor. The bypass capacitor also is 10 microfarads. So, also is 10 microfarads. Okay. So, now you have to vary the frequency from 50 hertz. So, where are you? This is your frequency. Fix it at 50 hertz. This is 50, starting with 50. Now let us see, add to the table. So for 50 hertz, the power is directly calculating the power. So actually we plot a graph between frequency and the output voltage. Output voltage by input, that is a gain. Gain versus frequency is what we plot. So in this particular lab, he is directly calculating the power at the output. And the power is measured in what is the unit is known as decibel. So the plot what you get is a frequency plot. For different frequencies you will be plotting this, and after you plot the graph, the graph contains three parts: the low frequency, the mid frequency and the higher frequency. Then from this power you consider 70.7% of the maximum. It cuts the graph at 2 points along the x-axis, draw the perpendiculars, find out the frequency at which this power is becoming 70.7%. That is when the power is getting reduced to half. They are also called as half power points. Then calculate the bandwidth. Okay, so let us perform this experiment. So 50 is this. Now increase it to 100. 50. Maybe we will start with 500. You will need so many points, so you can. I will just show you how to do, then you can add. 500. You can prepare this tabular column in your notebook, serial number, frequency, and magnitude. Copy down the values what I am giving. You can do the experiment once again. You must do the experiment once again. I am just showing you how to do this. Then 1000. Add to the table. So it's increasing. As you can see, the power is increasing as the frequency is increasing. Next 500,000, let's put 1500. Yeah, I am taking these values. So it's again increasing. Now the increase is less. From 10 it became 28, from 28 it became 32. Now you should be very careful, it is a slow increase. Next 2000. It's almost fairly constant. 2000. Next, 2500. Okay, roughly let me add. So 33.7, slight increase. 2500 and 3000. Okay. So for 3000, still increasing. 4000. So it is becoming 34, still increasing. 6000 is what I am taking. 7000. Still increasing. Then 8000. What value are you getting? 34.446. Okay. So 10,000, what are you getting? 34. So remaining constant. It's almost into the mid band region. Then 16. Somewhere in between you take 24k, still mid band region. 67k, still mid band, still constant. 50k, what's happening? Still, now it is reduced. See, from 34.38, it is reduced to 34.27. So it's falling. Now let me take reading number 4, and then 87k, 34.11, reducing. So add this, change the frequency it says. Okay. Add to the table. Okay. It's reducing. Almost, no, it's reduced. See, this is 300 kilo, how much kilohertz? 3000 kilohertz, that means 3 megahertz this is. Just remember the scale, it is reduced. 3 megahertz, it is reduced. Further it will be reduced. This is 7000 kilohertz, that means 7 megahertz. See, there is a sharp fall. Then what have I taken now? What is the frequency? 240 kilohertz. From the 32nd, 6, it is again reduced. The last value, maximum value, I am taking 500 megahertz. It's falling. So what's happening, as you can see, it's increasing up to 33, 34. From 3000 onwards, it's mainly remaining constant. Till what point is remaining constant? Till 959 kilohertz, it is remaining constant. It is falling at what value? This value. What is this value? 3000 kilohertz, that means 3 megahertz, 7 megahertz, it is started falling. This is the final value. Have you all followed this? I'll make you people do now. First, let us see. Now, say plot. A beautiful graph you are able to get. Take the screenshot of this. The midband region is from this point to almost this point. The midband gain is this. The lower cutoff frequency, what is the lower cutoff frequency? 5k, almost 5k, where it is. The higher cutoff frequency is 2 into 10 to the power 7. That means if you write it as 10 power 6, it will be 20 megahertz almost. Beautiful graph you are getting, a very good bandwidth. Bandwidth is higher cutoff frequency minus lower cutoff frequency. So 5k is lower cutoff frequency. The higher cutoff frequency is 200k. So almost 150 kilohertz is the bandwidth. Just make a note of this. Take the screenshot of this. So what you have to do is, I've already created an assignment. This is an online, all of you are expected to do this. You vary from 50 hertz, it's only a virtual lab that you are doing. So from 50 hertz, for every, I think 100 hertz you can take. 50, 100, 150, many points, as many points as you take, your graph will be as close as possible and you will be able to get. So what you should do is, what is the maximum gain you are getting? Maximum gain is 34 point something. Take 0.77707 of 0.34. How much it will be? Let me take it as 34, roughly I'm taking 24. So what you should do is around 24. So at 24, somewhere around here, you draw a line parallel to x-axis. If you draw a line parallel to x-axis, it is cutting at this point as well as this point. Draw perpendiculars, they will give you two. So I repeat, after plotting the graph, take the screenshot. The procedure I am telling you, 34 point is the maximum point, again, take 70.7% of the maximum, that is this value, draw a line parallel to x-axis, it will cut at this point and this point. This is called the lower cutoff frequency. You can hold here, you will know. And this is your upper cutoff frequency, which is already given to you. So calculate bandwidth. Bandwidth is high frequency cutoff minus low frequency cutoff. You can even print it. Then take it as a PDF and save it.
Ma'am,
yeah.
The base resistance, as per the instructions, the base resistance should be taken 47 kilo ohms, no, ma'am. But here, the starting is 100, ma'am.
Base, this is source resistance.
Yes, ma'am, in the base resistance, I'm telling. Base this thing, resistance. Ma'am, fourth point. Four. I mean, fifth point, ma'am. Fifth.
Uh-huh. What is it given?
Said
47k. What did it take? 47k only. 47,000 ohms is 47.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
So this is. Have you all understood the experiment? Is it clear? These readings you can copy, but you do the experiment again, and I want you people, each one of you. This is only a reference. You can use different setup. You need not take this. And different values, three different sets of readings. You must set one, set two, set three. You get different frequency responses, different lower cutoff frequency, higher cutoff frequency, and mid-band gain. We will observe the readings. All of you, this is, are you all able to see it on your mobile? So, if you finished copying, what I expect you people to do is take three different sets of readings, three different values of your resistances, different frequency ranges, plot the graph, take the screenshot. You have to tabulate these results also. Tabulate the results and take a screenshot of this figure and all put them all together in one single PDF file and upload it as an assignment. I would like to see how you are getting it. If you all have followed, what I would like to do is, now I want one of you to present it.